I've got this webpage with a picture of Winston. It's getting cold here, and Winston is getting old, so he wishes he had a beard. I could draw the beard myself, but I think it'd be way cooler if the user could draw the beard on Winston themselves, however they want it to look. A long beard, some stubble, whatever they're into. So how could we do that? One way is to add an event listener for the Mousemove event on the image so that our function would get called whenever the user moved their mouse over the face. Let's set that up using what we just learned. The first step is to find the element, the image. So var face equals document.get element by ID face, since it had that nice ID. The second step is to define the callback function. And we're going to start with a simple one just to make sure that it worked. And we'll make it do more later. So document.getElement by ID message.textContent plus equals move. Okay. And the final step is to connect this to this to make sure that this gets called when this gets the mouse move event. So we'll write face.addEventListener mouseMove and then pass it the name of the function onMouseMove. Now, pause the talk through and try moving your mouse over the face. Do you see the message? Okay, hopefully you saw that we've got that event working, but it's not what we want our event listener to do. We want it to draw, not to write text. How can we draw in a web page? We could bring in the canvas tag and draw pixels on it like we do with processing JS programs here. But all we're drawing is a beard, which is really a bunch of black dots. So we could just create a div for each dot and position that div with absolute positioning. Here, let me show you with one beard follicle. So I'll make a div with class beard, and then I've got some nice CSS to style that beard, which I'll just stick in here. And let's just fix that up. So you can see our beard has a black background. It's 5x5 pixels. It's got this 2 pixel border radius to make it a little bit round, and it's using absolute positioning scheme. Currently, the div shows up under the image. How do we get it to show up on top of the face? We're using absolute positioning, so that means that we should use the top and left properties to say, you know, where it should actually get positioned now that it's absolute. So we'll say top 80 pics, and then left 15 pics. Beautiful. Now that we've got that working in HTML, let's make it work in JavaScript so that the user dynamically creates this div every time they move their mouse. Go back down to our JavaScript callback function. The first thing is to create a div, which we can do with our document.createElement function. It's going to be a div. Second thing to do is to add that class, beard.className equals beard. So we've got this div. It's floating off in space. Final step, append it to the body. All right, so now we've basically done in JavaScript what we had done in HTML, so we can delete this HTML. Now you should pause the talk through and try clicking Winston, see what happens. Did you see the beard follicle show up? And did you try clicking multiple times? If you did, you probably noticed that your second click did nothing, or at least it appeared to do nothing. That's because every div has the same top and left properties, so new ones just pile on top of the old ones. We want the div to show up wherever the user's mouse is instead. How do we actually find out where the user's mouse is? As it turns out, the browser records a lot of information every time any user event happens, like where it happens. And the browser gives you that information every time it calls your event listener function. But where? How can we get this amazing information? I'll type one letter, give you a hint. That E here is the event information object, and the browser sends it as the first argument whenever it calls an event listener callback function. We didn't need it before, so I didn't bother writing out the arguments list, but now that we're going to use it, I'm giving it a name to make it easy to reference inside the function. Remember that in JavaScript, a function can be called with any number of arguments, even if the function doesn't use or refer to any of them. So we were always getting this information, we just didn't know it. Now I'm going to log out E. Console.log E. Pause the talk through, click Winston, and check your console. You should see the event object logged out, and you can skim through all the properties on it. There are two event properties in particular that we're very interested in, client X and client Y. They record the X and Y of the event, and that's what we're going to use to position the beard. Let's set the top of the beard equal to e.clientY plus pics for the units, and set the left equal to e.clientX plus pics for units. Now pause and try mousing over. Draw Winston a beard. Pretty cool, huh? I bet you can imagine all sorts of fun painting apps that you can make using client X and client Y. And as you saw in the console, there were a bunch of other properties on the event object that you could use as well. The most useful, I think, are the keyboard related ones, so that you can find out what keys the user was pressing when an event happened, and use that to make a keyboard accessible interface or a really fun game. Oh, and one more thing, you don't have to call this argument E. That's typical, but some developers call it EVT or EVENT. It doesn't matter what you call it, as long as it's referring to the first argument that the browser passes to your function, and as long as you then refer to it that way later as well. If you're having trouble with it, make sure you use console.log to help you debug what's going on. When you're a web developer, the console is pretty much your best friend ever. Use it.